Welcome everyone back to weekly weather updates, and this evening we're going to have a look at the latest radar, and then we'll have a look through all the various models as things are looking like it could be turning dry and fine for many areas throughout the rest of August. Of course, as ever with the UK, things are looking more encouraging and more likely to be dry and fine in the south, and further northwards there's always the threat of low pressure and weather fronts coming in with westerly winds. So at this stage, it's definitely looking encouraging for the south for fine and dry weather. Further northwards, still pretty unsure. So do remember, if you enjoy my videos, make sure you like and subscribe. And do remember to follow me on Twitter as well. Link's in the description. So you can see at the moment, we do have high pressure near and towards the south of the UK. Further northwards, we have lower pressure. But it's not amazing lows. There's not massive widespread showers. But there are a few, of course, heavier showers around and a few maybe small cells have popped off. It's been fairly pleasant today, being around 20, 21, 22 degrees in many areas. We did see some more drizzle in the south as we saw those weather fronts that affected many areas in the west yesterday eventually clear from the southeast. But it hasn't really been too hot at all. And do make sure you check out my video earlier where we saw there was a new European record down in Sicily of 48.8 degrees for the heat wave that we've got going on right now in the Mediterranean. We're really not too far away, but temperatures here are around 25 to 30 degrees cooler, literally in the space of the height of France. So yeah, ridiculous temperatures seeing that there, so do check that video out. But at the moment, we're in under pretty pleasant conditions and we're not anywhere near 30 or 40 degrees at this stage. So if we do run through the GFS, see what the weather is looking at. So we're going to see we got this low pressure system out to the northwest of Scotland and Northern Ireland and parts of Ireland as well. And that's going to be driving in those showers that we've seen today and over the next few days. That low will eventually sort of dissipate and fill in, still potentially bringing a few showers here and there. And then we go into a sort of a northwesterly wind. We do have this brief low pressure system developing on Sunday. We have to really keep an eye on that, because the more that develops and the more that stays intact, the more rain we'll see along that and more shower activity. This stage, the latest GFS, does dissipate it quite significantly. And we do go into this quite weird northwesterly wind, where we see some quite warm air comes in from the northwest, being driven up by the jet stream from America, up the east coast towards Greenland, Iceland, and then dipping down towards the UK. Now, it's quite hot and humid air, and it's going to be picking up a lot of moisture as it goes across the ocean, over the Atlantic. So we'll look at the latest UK Met Office run, but it's looking very showery, a lot of drizzle, low cloud potentially with this, especially further northwards and westwards. Very weird precipitation chart, so keep an eye out at the end of the video as I'll show that. But yeah, very weird northwesterly wind being so warm, that eventually will sort of dissipate away. It could bring some decently temperatures in the middle of the day, especially further south and eastwards, where we have less of that cloud and drizzle as the air dries up a little bit as it goes over the land. We could see mid-20s potentially with that sort of upper air temperatures. Beyond that, we do maintain this sort of north or northwesterly regime, but we do see high pressure starting to build in. Now, the GFS is a bit of an outlier compared to the other models, with high pressure building in but getting pushed away by this small low pressure system that's coming down from Scandinavia, and you can see the high pressure that we want centred over the top of the UK is just squeezed out to our west, and we do continue bringing in some cooler northerly winds. Now, not especially cold or anything, but just cooler, and we'll have, of course, some showers on its northern and eastern side of the UK. But as we get towards the end of the run, very uncertain time frame, we do start to see westerly winds come in with cooler temperatures, a classic sort of zonal outlook. So a bit interesting there from the GFS. It's not really lining up with what I've seen from the other models and from the ensembles from around day 10, but it's very uncertain at this stage. So we'll have to just see which sort of models do come out right, this GFS run or the other models and ensemble members. But it is looking encouraging for high pressure building in. This latest GFS, of course, did have low pressure starting to edge in from the north and east. But many of the other models, I'll show you in a few seconds, have that high pressure firmly over the top of the UK, making it looking quite likely we're going to be seeing some fine and dry weather. So if we do run through the latest ECMWF, you can see low pressure to our north, and that low that eventually does dissipate through Saturday to Sunday does move through, potentially bringing some more shower activity widely. And then we get that really weird northwesterly wind with a lot of showers, low cloud coming in on it. some quite bizarrely warm air coming from our northwest. But as we head towards day 10, you see the Azores High extend up from the southwest. And by day 10, we've got a big area of high pressure, 1,030 millibars over the top of the UK. You can see by the 850 HP temperatures, it's not amazingly warm, but it's not cold. It's going to be around mid-20s. You can see the warmest air is actually over northern Scotland and over parts of northern England, Ireland as well, where we could see temperatures get up to the mid to high 20s, where we do see clear skies. Of course, there are westerly winds just to the north of the high pressure, which could influence the northern parts of Scotland briefly at times, but we'll just have to keep an eye on those small details nearer the time. But it's looking encouraging, sort of in 8, 9, 10 days, for that sort of 21st, 22nd of August time, to see high pressure build in. Quite strong air of high pressure as seen on CCMWF. And we have been having a look at this the last few days, so it's not come out of the blue. And we have been seeing these signs build up, and it's looking pretty encouraging now that the ECMWF and, you'll see in a minute, the GEM are both going for it, along with many of the GFS ensembles. So if we do go through the GEM, you see the low pressure system moving through at the moment, then we've got that other small low moving through. And then, of course, we get that really bizarre northwesterly wind before, as we head towards sort of a week tomorrow, we see high pressure starting to build in from the southwest. Now, this high pressure is a little bit more, a little weak. It's only 1,025 millibars, and it's building up from the south rather than sort of the southwest in off the Atlantic. That very subtle change in direction it builds up from does mean the upper air temperatures are going to be that bit warmer on the GM run. You can see here we're getting the 10, if not 12, if not sort of 13, 14, 15 degree isotherm through in the south and southwest, which would give temperatures, of course, into the mid to high 20s, if not 30 degrees potentially, if we do get dry, fine weather combined with sort of that 15 degree isotherm. So very interesting to see that. And hopefully, if all those hot and dry weather fans, that does come off. Now, it probably is on the warmer end of the ensembles, as we'll see in a minute. But it does show that we've got encouraging signs for this last third of August that things at least are going to be turning drier, which I think everyone can agree is a good sort of outcome. Temperatures, of course, still will depend on the air mass we are in. But again, as ever, this time of year is summer. We've got strong sunshine, so it doesn't really matter what upper air temperatures we'll have. It still will feel relatively pleasant getting into the mid-low 20s, even if we did only have 5 or 10 degrees at 850 HPA. So we do have a look at the GFS ensembles. You can see this well reflected. Right now, we've got a little bit up and down as we've got westerly winds coming in. Then we see that really bizarre northwesterly wind coming in over the next few days towards the weekend and next week, where we do see some quite warm upper air temperatures come in for a brief period of time. And then we go just to around average or below average as we've got sort of nice northerly winds coming in. But it is relatively dry, coming from a dry direction with some dry air. And we do have relatively high pressure around. So we'll be some showers, but not too much as we head into the longer term. Sort of 10-day time frame, you look at the 22nd, you do see a lot of ensemble it's getting up to 10, 12 degrees at 850 HPA, and some really taking off after that, getting up to maybe 20, 22 degrees at 850 HPA, and pretty low precipitation as well. You can see it's not set in stone. There are a lot of other ensemble members keeping temperatures around average, if not a little bit cooler, with a few precipitation signals, precipitation spikes. So you can see it is 10-day time frame, so it is relatively uncertain, and we'll just have to really see what does come off. But it's looking encouraging, both the GM and the ECMWF building in high pressure over the top of the UK. GFS has high pressure around, but not quite the most dominant feature. And you see many of the ensemble members are going quite warm and dry as well. We also have a look at what the outlook is in Glasgow, give us a better perspective of what we're going to see up north. You can see we do get a drier period as we do have high pressure building in, and as we got those winds coming in from the north. As it is the longer term, there's a lot more uncertainty. You can see there are quite a few precipitation signals from a few of the ensemble members. You can see temperatures are getting to around average or above average. So a little bit different there. So potentially, this is a signal where we see high pressure building in from many parts of the country, bringing in warmer air. But just to the north, in Scotland potentially, we do continue being in westerly winds. Although it is under a warm air mass, we will still see showers around. So we just have to see that northern extent of the high pressure at this stage. But it is looking increasingly encouraging for many areas of England, Wales and Ireland. Scotland, Northern Ireland, and probably Northern England, still a little bit up in the air exactly how much this high pressure is going to be under influence. It looks pretty encouraging for the south at this stage, as ever. With the summer, always we're going to see the higher temperatures in the south, and with the probably nor or at least normally we would see the dry weather as well. But this year it's a bit all over the place, really. So if we do finally have a look at the latest from the UK Met Office at the precipitation rate, and then we'll have a look at the temperatures as well. So you can see through Friday, we do see a few showers, of course, in northern Scotland as we've got westerly winds moving in. Maybe a few showers elsewhere. But that low pressure in Scotland really is driving a few those quite frequent showers. Not too heavy, but frequent across Scotland, Northern Ireland, Northern England perhaps. And then as we head towards Saturday, you can see the potential of that little system. It is filling in. So it's not going to be too significant, bringing in some more persistent rain and a few showers. And you can see overnight Sunday does pep up a little bit through central areas of England, potentially bringing in some more rain as that moves through. So a bit of rain there potentially. Doesn't look like a deluge by any means, but something to keep an eye on. And then through Monday, we have that really weird northwesterly wind. And you can see the bizarre sort of precipitation charts with a lot of light rain. Really not too much heavy rain in it, but really quite widespread light rain as we've got that hot humid air meeting the mountains being driven upwards, and we're seeing a lot of low cloud and some drizzly precipitation around, and that eventually does spread south and eastwards, breaking up a little bit, and then we just consistently get a lot of light showers around. So very weird, this northwesterly wind coming in. Never really seen it on the models before, but a unique scenario where we've got warm upper air getting travelled by the jet stream in from the northwest. So if we do have a look at the max temperatures at 1.5 meters, if we do look through Friday, you can see temperatures in the afternoon getting around 22, 23 degrees for many areas of England, areas of Wales, Scotland, Northern England, and Ireland, around high teens, maybe even get towards 20 degrees. So around average, really. And then as we head into Saturday, we do see temperatures again, 23, 24 degrees in the far southeast, potentially again mid to high teens, maybe low 20s elsewhere. And as we head through to Sunday, as we see those quite warm upper air temperatures come in from the northwest, we do see a pattern where temperatures are down to around 20, 21 degrees, but that's because we've got a lot of cloud and drizzle around. The air mass is pretty warm, and you can see over the mountains only 8, 9 degrees, whereas over the sea, 14, 15 degrees. It's simply because the amount of low cloud and drizzle around will feel pretty humid under that air mass. So it'll be interesting to see what sort of conditions we do see from that. Then as we head through Tuesday, again, potentially an average day with temperatures around 20 degrees or so, as that sort of northwesterly wind does clear through. So it is looking encouraging. We're going to be seeing some drier and finer weather around, especially in the south. In the north, a little bit more more uncertain. But this stage, we've got a few sort of northwesterly winds and northerly winds to contend with over the next sort of week or so, which are going to bring a lot of showers potentially in the north, and then maybe some widespread showers elsewhere at times. But it's not really looking like an absolute deluge of what we've seen recently, which is encouraging. It does seem like there are going to be plenty of pleasant days around, and I know a lot of people will enjoy that. So anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you again for another video soon.